Welcome to Lexington, Kentucky, and Rupp Arena for NCAA Women's Gymnastics in the SEC. The stars are already out in 2023 in what is arguably the best conference in women's gymnastics. Trinity Thomas, Suni Lee, number one and two in the country last year, while Kyla Bryant and Raina Worley, Haley Bryant, I say Kyla Bryant every damn time. I shouldn't say her name. Try to lead their teams. Who will challenge the Florida Gators for the SEC team championship? We are going to find out.
Sorry, our ISO is not working, so we can't see.
Yeah, I couldn't see that.
No.
I was just guessing on what was going on. Maybe I can pronounce Kentucky too. Welcome to Lexington, Kentucky, and Rupp Arena for NCAA Women's Gymnastics in the SEC. The stars are already out in 2023. Trinity Thomas, Suni Lee, number one and number two in the country in 2022, while Haley Bryant and Raina Worley will lead their teams, LSU Tigers and the Kentucky Wildcats, here in a 12 versus 10 matchup. Who will challenge the Florida Gators for the top of the spot in the SEC this year? We will find out. And with the return of intra-competition in the SEC, it's the return of Friday Night Heights. And tonight, Georgia visits Missouri at 7 p.m. And then Alabama, they go to Arkansas following that at 8:30 p.m. on the SEC Network. And right after us, maybe the meat of the year, Auburn goes down to Gainesville to take on the number two Florida Gators at the O'Connell Center. Welcome to SEC on ESPN. Hello, everyone. I'm John Roethlisberger alongside Alicia Quinn, and we are at Excite Night at the University of Kentucky. A big night here for Kentucky gymnastics, always one of the biggest crowds of the season for them, and they have got a lot of high hopes for their season. And speaking of the season, SEC Conference is arguably the best conference in women's gymnastics. It's got to be an exciting night for all of us.
It is the second week of women's gymnastics, but first week of conference action, and these two teams have a great matchup tonight. But honestly, I'm biased. I think the SEC is the toughest conference in women's gymnastics. All eight teams are ranked top 20 in the nation.
Well, let's talk about two of the teams. LSU is number 10. They come here to number 12, Kentucky. This is going to be a tightly contested one, it feels like.
The last time these two teams met, Kentucky just inched away with the win over LSU by just half a tenth. So LSU is coming back to look for conference dominance tonight here in Rupp.
And that competition last year was in Baton Rouge, and it was a controversial one.
Yeah, now I can see it. That's fine. So it's Haley.
Oh, yeah, you're
going to talk
about it. Sorry, you're going to talk about the athletes.
Sorry, I had to move around my chair. That was my fault. Okay. Okay.
Good. Perfect.
For the four. Okay, cool. All right,
welcome
cool.
Welcome to Lexington, Kentucky. Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
I don't need to say the SEC Conference because it's the Southeast Conference.
Hey, that's why we practice, to mess
exactly
up beforehand. Hey.
Welcome to Lexington, Kentucky and Rupp Arena for NCAA Women's Gymnastics in the SEC. The stars are already out in 2023, including Trinity Thomas and Suni Lee. They were 1-2 in the country last year. Can they do it again? Haley Bryant for LSU and Raina Worley for Kentucky will lead their squads in a 10-12 matchup here in Lexington. Who can challenge the SEC champs, the Florida Gators? Can they get it done again this season? And with the first week of intra-conference competition in the SEC, that means a return of Friday Night Heights on the SEC Network at 7 p.m. tonight. The Georgia Bulldogs go to Missouri to take on the Tigers, while right after that at 8:30, Alabama, they go to Arkansas to take on the Razorbacks. And right after us on ESPN2, maybe the meat of the year, a top five matchup. The Auburn Tigers, they go down to Gainesville to take on the number two team in the country, the Florida Gators. This is the SEC on ESPN. We're in Rupp Arena, and it's Excite Night, and that means it's going to be a big one for the Kentucky Wildcat Gymnastics program. Big crowd tonight, always the biggest one for them of the year, and it's going to be a great matchup as they welcome the LSU Tigers. Hello, everyone. I'm John Roethlisberger alongside many-time world medalist, one of the greatest ever, Alicia Quinn. Big night here in the SEC, the first week of intra-conference competition for these teams.
I know I'm biased. I think the SEC is the toughest conference in women's gymnastics because all eight schools are ranked in the top 20, which will guarantee you a great matchup every week when you are doing interconference action. And tonight is no different.
We'll talk about tonight. LSU comes to town. They're number 10. The home team, Kentucky Wildcats, are number 12. Feels like it's going to be a close one.
LSU has been relying heavily on Haley Bryant. She has just been a force in her 3 years at school. But she has some help from Kaya Johnson, who's been in and out of the all-around and just so consistent in everything this LSU Tiger squad needs. But Kentucky has an all-arounder all of their own. Raina Worley has been dominating for this team and knows what to do when she needs to perform. But she has some help from Jillian Kopaski. I'm going to mess up her name for sure.
Kopaski, just like it's looks.
She was 22 freshman of the year. I'll get my crap together for that one. Jillian Prokaski.
2022, freshman of the year.
Yeah. Got it.
Last year, good.
Besides that last part, I'll fix it, don't worry.
Yeah. Was that? Ailey Bryant for LSU and Raina Worley for Kentucky might have something to say about it. They are also two stars that have already shown in week one. Can the Florida Gators defend that SEC team title? Who's it going to be in 2023? And with the first week of intra-team competition here in the SEC, that means the return of Friday Night Heights. And that means Georgia goes to Missouri tonight at 7 p.m. Alabama, they visit the Arkansas Razorbacks at 8:30. That is on the SEC Network and maybe the best matchup of the season. Number 5, Auburn, goes to Gainesville to take on the number 2, Florida Gators. This is the SEC on ESPN. Here in Rupp Arena, it is Excite Night. One of the biggest nights of the season for the Kentucky Wildcat women's gymnastics team. Big crowds, a lot of energy, and they bring it to the big stage, Rupp Arena. Hello, everyone. I am John Roethlisberger alongside 11-time world medalist, one of the best ever, Alicia Quinn. Alicia, a very exciting week for gymnastics in the SEC, maybe the best conference in the country.
I agree with you. I think the SEC is the toughest conference in all of women's gymnastics. All 8 teams are ranked in the top 20 in the nation. So that means every week there's conference play, it's a good week. And tonight is no different. LSU versus Kentucky, Rupp Arena. Last time these two teams met, Kentucky inched over a win over the Tigers at home. So LSU is looking for conference domination tonight in Rupp Arena. And two of their athletes that are helping him lead the way is Haley Bryant. She has just been a force for this team, the 2021 NCAA vault champion. And her teammate, upperclassman Kaya Johnson, she holds it down in the all-around. She has only put up 7 tens in her career, but Kentucky has an all-arounder all of their own. Raina Worley is the 2022 first team All-American in the all-around, and she proves herself each and every week. But she has some help from underclassman Jillian Prokaski, has been proving her worth as the season has started. That's fine. Okay. Okay, I don't need it. We can talk about it some other time. That's fine. Okay, no worries.
A senior from Dallas, Texas, Caitlin DeGuzman. First team All-American and 13-time all-around champion, a senior from Christiansburg, Virginia, Raina Junior from San Diego, California, Carissa Wade.
what the judges take away from our score when they see a mistake, such as a bent arm, a leg separation, or the dreaded step on a landing. The judges take these deductions. Is dropped. Other five give us our total. That brings us to our fourth. At the end of the fourth rotation, from all of the events, and if things have gone well, the Cats will win. Corey, get ready to cheer us on. Go Cats!
Welcome to Lexington, Kentucky and Rupp Arena for NCAA Women's Gymnastics in the SEC. The stars are already out in 2023, including defending champ Trinity Thomas, Olympic champion and all-around runner-up Suni Lee of Auburn, and Haley Bryant and Raina Worley are ready to help lead their teams to the top of the conference. The Florida Gators were the team champs in 2022. Who's it gonna be in 2023? And with the return of intra-conference competition this week in the SEC, that means it's the return of Friday Night Heights. And the Georgia Gym Dogs go to Missouri tonight at 7 p.m., followed by the Alabama Crimson Tide visiting Fayetteville, taking on the Arkansas Razorbacks at 8:30 p.m. That is on the SEC Network. And then right after us here on the ESPN2, Auburn, number 5 Auburn, goes to number 2 Florida in what might be the best matchup of the year. They will be in Gainesville. This is the SEC on ESPN. And here in Lexington, it is Excite Night, one of the best nights of the year for women's gymnastics for the Kentucky Wildcats. Big crowds, tons of energy, and of course, a great gymnastics matchup. Hello, everyone. I'm John Roethlisberger, joined once again, it seems like we never get together anymore, by one of the greatest ever, Alicia Quinn. Alicia, it's so exciting to have conference competition here in the SEC, arguably the best conference in the country.
It definitely is. The SEC has so much talent and depth. All 8 schools are ranked in the top 20 in the nation. And so that means every week of conference play is going to be a great week of gymnastics. And tonight is no different. LSU versus Kentucky, we are going to have some standout athletes. LSU has Haley Bryant, who has just been an absolute force, the 2021 NCAA vault champion. And then Kaya Johnson, she has been putting up numbers in the all-around for as long as I can remember in the last couple years, and she has been phenomenal. Kentucky has their very own all-arounder, though, Raina Worley. She is All-American in 2022, and she is just a force. But she has some help from underclassman Jillian Prokaski, who's been making her name known for this Wildcats team.
And talk about a matchup last year between these two teams. Kentucky went to Baton Rouge, and they won an incredibly close competition, half a tenth, and it was controversial. There was equipment failure. They had a routine that was repeated. Kentucky got the win. And here is Ashlyn LeClaire for the Wildcats trying to do it again.
Opens up with a big Yurchenko full slight leg separation in the air, but the judges will give her a small deduction for it, but a strong way to open for the Kentucky Wildcats.
The name of the game for the vault, stick those landings. Here are the rules for dual meets in women's gymnastics. Six gymnasts compete on each event. The top five scores on each event are the ones that are counted, and that is very important. They can drop the lowest, which sometimes is a miss. They obviously add up those five best scores on each event. That is your winner. The home team, as we just saw, Kentucky, they start on vault, go bars, beam, floor. That's what we call Olympic order. And the visiting team, the LSU Tigers, they got to start on bars. And here's Kaya Johnson, maybe not the easiest place to start the uneven bars.
You know, some athletes, it's all preference. Some athletes like being in that leadoff position, knowing that they can put up a strong score for their team and let the scores build after that. It takes somebody of a very strong mind to willingly like that spot. And Kaya is one of those gymnasts.
And Kaya is a senior out of Dallas, Texas. Texas Dreams was her club, coached by the legendary world champion Kim Zemeskal. Kaya is an incredible athlete. She was scheduled to do the all-around tonight, has been battling a bit of an Achilles injury really over her entire collegiate career, but they manage it really well, do the LSU Tigers. And you can see Jay Clark a little bit off to the side there in the gray jacket and purple shirt. And some of the keys here on uneven bars, Alicia.
What the judges are looking for is making sure you hit clean handstands. You need to have your release moves in your bar routine. That means you are letting go of the bar and catching the bar, that same bar or the different bar. And of course, the last thing the judges see and the first thing they're going to take deductions for, remember, is that landing on the dismount.
And I'm not sure what's going on right here. There has not been a routine before Kaya. So there shouldn't be any judges' conferences. I don't know if they're having an equipment failure or a scoring system.
Jay Clark's face being like, what is happening? There should be no reason for the delay. And Kaya's staying loose, trying to stay focused, keep her body warm.
One of my least favorite things as a gymnast is waiting for the judges, because you kind of have a routine before the routine, right?
Yes, a lot of athletes are mentally going through their routine, their corrections, what their coaches have told them, and it kind of messes up your flow if you go through it and then you're waiting and then you have to go through it again. So it's like we mentioned, it is a tough spot to be in, starting off and having to wait your turn, but...
You saw Jay Clark and Tim Garrison, the head coach from Kentucky, right there, having a discussion. Both the coaches ready to get things going.
Kaya starts on the low bar. Nice toss up to the high bar. Moving between the bars, hitting requirements. All gymnasts start from a 9.4, and then determining their skill value and connections will get them to start from a 10.0. And that was a 10.0 start value for sure for Kaya.
Wow.
But what will the score be? That was a nice set.
I mean, stand there and wait for an extra minute. Maybe that's the formula for Kaya Johnson, because I don't know if I've seen her do a better bar routine. That in the leadoff spot as well.
Kaya had great form throughout this bar routine. Nice, tight double layout. Sticks that landing. You are allowed to move your feet to have your heels touching, and that does not count as a deduction.
Now back over to vault, Jillian Prokaski. She is a sophomore, was scheduled to do the all-around, but has just been replaced on the uneven bars by Bailey Bunn. She will still be on three events, the first of which, obviously, here, the vault.
Approaching the table. Yurchenko full. Kicks her legs open at the end, but we get a different angle than what the judges are seeing. They don't have the behind-the-vault table like we have, so they may not see that leg separation as severe as we do. She does a round off onto the springboard, back handspring onto the table, full twist, kicks those legs open, and just a small step in the landing. But again, a very clean start. I know Coach Tim Garrison was looking for stuck landings.
You talked a lot about that, especially on the even bars. I think his exact words were, if we could just at least stick one bar landing. They did not stick any last week. Ashlyn LeClaire led off for Kentucky on vault. She scored a 9.85, very good first score up. We're still waiting for Kaya Johnson's score to come in. We expect it to be an outstanding score. Stuck the landing, hit some handstands. As we see Elena Arenas, she is a junior out of Athens, Georgia. Georgia Elite was her gym club, coached by her dad, Pete Arenas. Outstanding junior coach, one of the best in the country.
Jacqueline. It opens up with a big release move connected to immediate pack Salto, giving her bonus points to work towards that start value we mentioned.
We saw Kaya Johnson's 9.9 in the leadoff. Big score.
So far, so good. This routine has been relatively clean. Nice landing on that double layout.
Little slide, little foot slide, maybe a half, you think, Alicia?
It was a smidge of a movement.
Smidge.
A little smidge.
Is that in the code of points? Do they put
smidge?
Be.
A smidge should be in the code of points. But building momentum with those giants before her dismount. Double out. Ideally, you want to see those legs glued together throughout the flip. So the judges will deduct a little bit there, and of course, that smidge landing step we just discussed.
Now, Mackenzie Wilson, sophomore, up next. Now, Tim Garrison told us that he should have 410-0 vaults, which means the next four vaults should all start from a perfect 10.
Nice front handspring, pike, half vault. Not a vault we see very often, but we will see a few tonight
yep.
with these two teams. Start from a 10-0. Nice aggressive approach to the table at good height and distance.
Jillian Perkowski right before her, a 9.8. So 9.85, then a 9.8 so far for Kentucky. Here's another look.
The front pike with the half twist. What judges are really looking for is they want to see that tight body after she kicks out the half to open to bring her feet down. They want to see nice straight body. She piked just a smidge, but all in all, I like that vault.
So now Alexis Jeffrey, a sophomore from Warrensburg, Massachusetts, actually a UCLA transfer, came over after last season, actually during last season to LSU. This is the first chance you and I had a chance to see Alexis in person,
LSU.
And we were both standing on the side watching warm-ups, and we're like, who is that? Look at that. I mean, she had some amazing bar work, as we saw in the warm-ups. Now we'll see if that can transfer here to the competition.
Alexis starts on the low bar. Nice. The immediate pack Salto. Great form. Her toes, legs perfectly glued together. Just a bit short on that handstand. The judges give you within 10 degrees to get without deduction. Alexis is a little short, but that dismount finished the routine strong.
It looked a lot like the warm-up set we saw, especially the dismount. That just floats. Right before her, Elena Arenas, a 9.825. In the second spot, Mackenzie Wilson on vault, a 9.825 in the third spot. Now, Ariana Patterson for Kentucky. Still looking for that first stuck vault, and if they can get it on a 10-0 start value, it is going to be a huge number.
Ariana starting her approach. Another front pike half, and she's
there you go.
Landing. A girl after my own heart. I love a good front entry vault, and that was great. The nice arm circle that you can see the heel drive where she gets her body over the table to help initiate that flip. And she does not move those feet at all. Good height and distance. As you can see those two lines, a new deduction for this season is direction. So they need to land between those lines to not get any points off from their score.
Next on bars for LSU.
Beautiful vault for Ariana Patterson. Aaliyah Finnegan will be the next gymnast to go for LSU on the uneven bars. Aaliyah started a little slow last year, and that was largely by design by the LSU coaching staff. Had come off surgery before her freshman year. They brought her back slowly. By the end of the year, she looked very good, competed in the offseason internationally, and they said she is ready to go in the all-around this year.
It's all about preserving these athletes' bodies. They have very long seasons. They compete every week. So being very strategic with how you bring an athlete back is very important. And Aaliyah is looking like she is, you know, on her upward climb to peak at the right time of year for when postseason hits. Beautiful handstand on the high bar. Arabian double front blind landing, and she sticks it.
Incredible dismount. And again, we watched their bar warm-up. She had a trouble on a couple of those landings in the warm-up, but no problem right here.
The giant swings before the dismount. Let's go. Turns, double front forward, nails it. So you have to have very good air awareness to know where you are to be able to kick that out and not move those feet at all.
And she is going to get a big number because Alexis Jeffrey right before her at 9.9. Feels like the judges are going to have to go up with that one. As we jump back over to vault, Isabella Magnelli, the junior from Suffern, New York, follows Patterson's 9.9.
Front handspring pike ass. Oh! Woo! That was, I mean, I am so excited by the number of front handspring vaults we are seeing from this Kentucky squad.
You're the queen of the handspring entry, if I do remember.
I think I need to pass that crown over to one of the other gymnasts here tonight, but this was, you don't see many athletes doing it. It is harder to learn and perfect because it is so much momentum that you need to open up and control, but that was fantastic.
So far, the stuck landings have taken a step up for Tim Garrison. He talked a lot about that this week. Aaliyah Finnegan, a 9.9. So back-to-back 9.9s for LSU on bars. We talked about Patterson. She got a 9.9 of her own on vault. Now Alona Shanikova, also a big performer. She will be three events tonight for the LSU Tigers.
Opening up with a big release move, immediate pack salto. Alona has great lines. She's a fantastic bar worker. She's a taller gymnast, so when she really hits those handstands and accentuates her form, it looks beautiful. Double out dismount. Pikes it down a bit, tries to college step that landing to cover up the step she was taking, but finished the routine strong.
Alona, a former elite gymnast and two-time national team member out of Evergreen, Colorado. Isabella Magnelli, a 9.925 for Kentucky in the fifth spot. So two 9.9s or better for Kentucky now with just Raina Worley, their star senior. She does a Yurchenko 1.5, and Alicia, if she can stick this landing, this place is going to go crazy.
If Raina sticks her landing, you're right, this place will erupt. The crowd is so loud, and that is something these athletes feed off of. Nice approach to the table. Big Yurchenko 1.5, doesn't stick it, but that was a very well done vault. Nice form as her feet hit the springboard. Nice legs stuck straight together. She needed to get her head just around a second sooner and she would have been able to spot that landing mat to be able to stick that landing, but that was very well done.
Nice vault rotation for the Kentucky Wildcats. I think head coach Tim Garrison will be happy with that one. Pending Raina Worley's score, they are counting all scores above 9.8, maybe, depending on what Worley gets, maybe three scores of 9.9 or better. The last gymnast to go for LSU on the even bars. Another one of their stars, Haley Bryan, junior all-arounder out of Cornelius, North Carolina, and Everest Gymnastics. I am being told we have a judges conference over on the bars, and as I look over there, yes indeed, they're heading back to their chairs right now. While we're waiting, Raina Worley, a 9.85 for her vault. So they will actually drop a 9.8. They're going to count three scores in the 9.8, two in the 9.9s for a 49.35 for their first event total. They've got a 49.1 in the opening weekend of competition, did the Kentucky Wildcats. That was the 15th best score on that event. Here we got another waiting game, Alicia. It worked out well for Kaya Johnson, leadoff spot. See how it works out for Haley.
Haley is a very strong competitor, and she was staying loose. It's about finding that balance, being focused, but also not getting too tense before you have to get up on the apparatus. Beautiful straddle Jaeger. The height above the bar was just phenomenal.
So that 49.2 in the bottom right of your screen, that is still counting their low score. So if Haley Bryant scores higher than the lowest score they've had so far, that total will go up.
Double front half, and she sticks the landing.
And she will score higher than their low score so far, which is a 9.675 from Alona Shanikova. So that team total, bottom right, could go up as much as two or even three-tenths, depending on what the judges do.
Haley's lines are just exquisite. The extension, the double front with the half out, stunning. If I was on the judging side of things, that routine is like a 9.95 in my opinion. I don't know if anyone's feeling to throw a 10 because, you know, it's an emotional thing to do.
Jay Clark with some words to his team. He's also got to be thrilled with their first event rotation, the opening uneven bars of this conference season for both LSU and Kentucky. That is the first rotation. It's a fast-paced start to a competition, and it was a good one here at Rupp Arena. A lot more gymnastics yet to come. Welcome back to Women's Gymnastics here on ESPN. Your score, LSU takes an early lead, just under 2/10 over the home team, the Kentucky Wildcats. Long way to go yet, but those are two big numbers to start off with. And we see head coach, the third year as the head coach of the LSU Tigers, talking to his staff over there. Jay Clark, if anybody, he knows, he's been around the SEC his entire coaching career, and he knows how competitive this conference can be. Here's him talking about it.
Every single program in our conference virtually is a top 10 program and has the potential to win on any given day. That's great for our conference. That's iron sharpens iron. And I think we have such a tremendous group of coaches and leaders in positions now to direct their programs and to lead these young women in a positive way.
And Jay Clark knows coming into Lexington, even though they have a profound advantage as far as record over the Kentucky Wildcats, every season is a new season, and this is a different Kentucky Wildcat team. It's going to be a tough win for them to get tonight. We can see it's very close early after one rotation. LSU Tigers in the second rotation, they're going to go to vault led by their national champ, Haley Bryant. She does that. It's amazing. You'll see it as well as Caitlin DeGuzman and the Kentucky Wildcats. They're going to go to the uneven bars. Can they stick the landings like the Tigers did? They're going to need to keep pace. Welcome back to Lexington, Kentucky for women's gymnastics. And you can see LSU with a slight lead over the home team, the Kentucky Wildcats, led by Haley Bryant, 9.95 on the uneven bars. Alicia, a lot of great routines in that first rotation. What stands out to you?
For me, it was the 4.10 start value that Kentucky put up on vault, because that's what sets you apart in the SEC. If you have a lot of 10.0 start values in vault, you can make up a lot of points on that one event alone. But Haley Bryant's ending out that bar rotation for LSU was fantastic. I was very impressed with that routine.
So 0.175 separates these two teams after one rotation. The Kentucky Wildcats were led by Magnelli's 9.925 for her vault. Haley Bryant, dead center of your screen. She does that same vault we saw from a number of the Kentucky Wildcats, that handspring front pike half. You could argue no one on the planet Earth does it quite like Haley Bryant, though. If she can stick it, she can score a 10. And they're going to have to keep bringing it. No lead is comfortable here in the SEC. Elena Arenas starting things off on vault for the Tigers.
Elena opens up with the Yurchenko full, small steps on that landing.
Saw Elena on bars as well. She put up a 9.825 on that event in the two spot. See the first athlete up for Kentucky on the uneven bars. This is Haley Davis, Jr. from New Bern, North Carolina, and New Bern Gymnastics. Has a high score for her career on bars of a 9.875.
Haley starting up on the high bar. Nice straddle, Jaeger. Moving between the bars, hitting that bail to handstand. Coach Tim Garrison talked about sticking these landings. Let's see if Haley can score the trend. And she did.
They've already got at least two stuck landings on vault. Now they got one in the leadoff position on bars.
At this point, gymnasts are just looking for fine tuning. They can do these skills. They've been doing them a long time. It's about how perfectly they can conduct them. And this double layout was textbook.
Haley, a walk-on her freshman and sophomore year, and now has earned a scholarship in her junior year. Great story. What are some of the points of emphasis, Alicia, on the vault?
On vault, Your start value sets you apart. You want to start from a 10.0. Your amplitude, how high you're vaulting. And of course, if you stick that landing, it's going to benefit you in the end.
Here we go with senior Alona Shenikova at a 9.675 on the uneven bars, rotation one.
Chango, 1.5.
Oh.
Unfortunately, sits it down. Was needing a little bit more height in rotation to get her feet underneath her.
Just one of those vaults, too, if you're trying too hard to stick it and you're looking for that landing too much, maybe problem, Alicia?
Yes, definitely. If you're trying to control the landing too much, it's very easy to make that same mistake of sitting it down. It's happened to many a gymnast, and it's unfortunate, but LSU still has other athletes they can count their scores on.
And Jillian Prokaski, as we mentioned, was going to be in the second spot here for Kentucky on bars, but Bailey Bunn, coming back from injury, has really worked hard and is back in the lineup here tonight. Had a good warm-up, and I'm told by Tim Garrison right before the competition, she is in.
Line change to a straddle Jaeger. To bail. You see Coach Garrison moving between the bars. They are allowed to do that as long as they don't touch the athlete who's competing. It's perfectly okay for the athlete's safety for them to be there. Another double layout that stuck.
Did she hold it long enough?
That is the question.
Haley Davis ties a career high in the leadoff spot, 9.875 for her.
You see that she almost like double gripped her hand on that blind change, but kept the control of the Jaeger very well. Moved between the bars. And another look at that double layout. She almost picked that foot up. But if she turned and saluted quickly, maybe the judges will give it to her.
It's in the judges' hands now, which is really a scary thing to say in gymnastics.
It's all subjective, John. All subjective.
Now back over to vault. This is KJ Johnson. Alona Shenikova, a 9.125. Keep in mind, that score can be dropped. They count the top five. So with four gymnasts left, the pressure is on. They all have to hit. Otherwise, LSU will have to count a fall. And in a competition this tight and this close, when it can come down to tenths, or like last year, half tenths, that can be critical.
KJ making her way down the runway. A big Yurchenko full,
wow,
small hop on that landing. That was so high.
You will not see a bigger laid out Yurchenko full than KJ Johnson's.
No, the height she gets off the table, the amplitude that you see, she has enough time to kick that vault out and wait for her feet to float down to the ground. Absolutely beautiful.
You know, and in a hypercritical of sport like gymnastics, where perfection is sought at every turn, I guarantee KJ, that's like a miss to her.
Oh,
to take a hop.
Oh, she's not happy about that.
Absolutely. That is a huge vault, and you know it's all about the stuck landing for her. But that being said, that is still going to be a very good score. Annie Reigert now, a sophomore from Mason, Ohio, follows Bailey Bunn's 9.825.
Annie has a big Jaeger above the high bar. Keeping good rhythm in this bar routine. Building momentum. Double layout. A little bit tiny in her hip. Unfortunately, doesn't keep the stick train going for Kentucky, but it is another hit routine. And at this point in the season, when it's early on like this, you're getting used to competing again, and you're getting the jitters out of your system, and you really are focusing on hitting and making minor improvements each and every week.
One more look at the dismount.
So the judges are going to probably deduct her for that because she wasn't a set position. She wasn't piked enough for her to be piked, and she wasn't open enough to be a layout. So she'll definitely get deducted for that. And you can see the landing deductions here. A stick, no deduction. One small step or hop, 0.1 or less. Larger step hop, 0.2. And then if you fall, it is a half a point deduction.
Aaliyah Finnegan next to go on vault. KJ Johnson on a 9.95 start value, got a 9.875. That is a season high. Obviously just two meets in, but a very good score.
Lead a half on front.
Beautiful.
Pike. Nice vault. Does take that step backwards. So typically when you do a front landing skill and you step backwards, they consider that under rotating it. So ideally you either want to stick or make a step forward that shows you had enough momentum completing the skill.
It's just that impression in the judge's mind.
Yep.
A step forward and a step back really shouldn't matter, but it does, right?
Exactly. The deduction for the step is the same. It's 1/10 or more.
So again, coming into the second rotation, 0.175 separated these two teams, and it just feels like the Wildcats are chipping away a little bit. If they can stick a couple more landings here on bars, as Caitlin DeGuzman is the next gymnast to go.
Caitlin does a nice Jaeger to immediate overshoot. Tad bit short on that handstand on the high bar. Double layout. That was stuck double layout.
You know, she looked right at Tim Garrison when she turned around, and it's almost like, I told you I could stick. And they have brought
amazing.
3 out of 4 so far, stuck landings on bars.
She gets nice height above the bar for this. Nice, tight, laid out form. And throws the head back to really just emphasize that she stuck the landing and had that control.
So Aaliyah Finnegan on vault, just a 9.75. That hop backwards, I don't want to say you told them so, Alicia, but I think you told them so. They hit her real hard on that. So two vaulters yet to go. One is Kaya Johnson right here.
Kaya's an excellent vaulter. Does it? Yurchenko double full, fighting for that stick. Putting the stick crown. Reigning the queen.
Small step or hop, a tenth or less. Was this a tenth or less?
She had good form in the air. I would say less. Less than a tenth.
How about the staggered feet on the landing? Is she opening herself up for potential deduction there?
How nitpicky are we going to be here tonight, John?
Pretty nitpicky.
Then yes, according
to the judges,
they
are on the road in the SEC. You go on the road in the SEC, don't expect to get the benefit of the doubt. You got to be a little extra perfect.
All right, if we're going real nitpicky, they're going to not like that she wasn't fully rotated all the way around because her feet weren't even and she took that step. If I'm being super critical, but.
See, you are super critical. Shaylin Luksic is the next one to go. She follows a 9.8 from Caitlin DeGuzman. A 9.9, rather. I apologize. 9.9 from Caitlin DeGuzman.
Shaylin opens up with a nice big release move. Toe handstand to bail. Getting ready to finish this bar set. Double layout to a stick. The atmosphere in here is getting a little rowdy.
With every stuck landing, it just keeps getting a little bit louder.
Another beautiful body position in the air, just perfectly straight. Quick flips, I love that. That was a great bar routine for Kentucky.
Here we go. I've said before, maybe the best single piece of gymnastics done in all of the country, Haley Bryant.
My favorite ball in the nation
because
it's just so pretty.
We saw some outstanding vaults just like that from Kentucky, but man, she takes it to another level.
There's just a difference in the height she gets off the table, her body position in the air, and the distance. Look how far she is. It's an absolutely very well done and executed vault.
And as open as she is, basically in the laid out position almost throughout, she still has too much power and takes that hop backward. We had a chance, Alicia and I had a chance to see her in the lobby of the hotel when we were coming over. Just an amazing person, modest and humble, but just you can tell she's got that something different, right?
She's very special, a very sweet young lady. And I just joke around, I'm like, when did you get so tall? It's just like, I don't remember you being this tall, but I think I'm also shrinking, so it could be
when
that.
Did we get so short,
I think
is the
question.
Real question. Haley Bryant gets a 9.9 for that vault. Now one more gymnast to go for Kentucky on the uneven bars. This is Raina Worley. We've got issues in the stands. You can see Tim Garrison talking to somebody. Now, one of the issues in gymnastics is flash photography, and that is something that can definitely distract a gymnast. And there may be some of that. I'm not going to say for sure, but that is something we have seen in the past.
That could be something that is causing Coach Garrison to just, you know, take an extra step for the safety of the athletes. It can be blinding. It can be distraction.
And that is something that a lot of fans, it's not malicious. You don't realize it. So hopefully it's something as simple as that as we wait to have them get that cleared up. Jalen Luksic, a 9.925. That is a career high score for her. So four scores for the Kentucky Wildcats that are at or above career highs. What a rotation. Tim Garrison's really done a great job building up this Kentucky Wildcat program since he got here, brought them to new heights, just missed making it to the NCAA championships last year. Kind of a heartbreaker. They actually beat Auburn in the first day of the regionals, but then lost to them in the finals of the regionals to go to the NCAA championships, and that cost them a trip to be one of the last eight teams competing for the season. But he really believes the team he has now doesn't have a weakness. He feels like they can get there this year. They just have to hit and stick landings, and so far tonight, they've done that.
I gotta respect that Coach Garrison is fighting for his athletes as much as he is. He's like, no, they're not going until I feel comfortable and safe enough for them to compete and do so, and I love that.
Here we go, Lena Worley in the anchor position.
Nice big tapacha for Reyna. Just keeps getting better each year. She's like a fine wine that just gets better with age. Her gymnastics is completely under her control, and she's a great competitor. Full twisting double tuck. Hop on that landing, but that was a fantastic bar routine for Reyna Worley.
Good finish for the Wildcats, and what looks to be a very solid score for them here in the second rotation. One more look at the dismount.
She got great height. Just held her body shape a little bit too long. If she kicked those legs out a little bit sooner, she'd be able to absorb that landing.
So we're finishing up rotation two, and we actually get the pleasure of speaking with the head coach of the LSU Tigers, Jay Clark. Jay, we talked a little bit about last year's meet with the Kentucky Wildcats down at your place, and it was one to remember. And I'm sure as you come here, you don't forget the equipment malfunction. They get to go again. I know you and Tim have a good relationship,
yeah.
But you know, you got to give them some ribbing. You want a little payback tonight, right?
You know what? We're just trying to do the best we can in here tonight. This is a great environment here at Rupp. And Tim and I disagree on that particular interp for sure, but we're buddies, and we don't let that stuff get in the way.
Coach, you're halfway through this competition. Your team's doing well. What do you tell them going into third event?
Well, they got to recapture some momentum. I thought we really did a good job coming out firing on bars really well and kind of let some things go a little bit on vault. I think they let scores bother them, and you can't do that. And so we got a little bit flat there, but we'll pick it back up. Floor's a good event for us. We just need to go over there. We're halfway home. We just got to get over there and knock it out.
Thanks, Jay. Keep up the great work, and good luck in the second half.
Thanks, guys.
Jay Clark talked to us before this competition a lot about that, about the mental game for his team and how they need to be mentally tough and they need to grind and not get thrown off by things like the scores that he mentioned right there. But I tell you what, they still got a half a tenth lead, and for not a great vault rotation by their standards, they've got to be pleased with that. The Kentucky Wildcats, they brought it on the uneven bars, and they have set it down and said last year was not a fluke. We want this win again. Last year was the Oklahoma Sooners. They were the national champions, and they are just doing what they always do, like another day at work. Getting it done in a close one against the Florida Gators. Special Martin Luther King Day schedule. Oklahoma, they go against the team we're seeing tonight, the 10th-ranked LSU Tigers. Oklahoma again in the spot they know well, ranked number one in the country. Then we got a special quad meet in Athens, Georgia, Ohio State, Rutgers, and the 20-ranked Gym Dogs, as well as Fisk University. Fisk becoming the first HBCU to compete at the NCAA level as we celebrate Martin Luther King Jr. weekend. We want to acknowledge that history was made last weekend when Fisk University competed in their first competition, the first HBCU to have an NCAA gymnastics team. And they took us behind the scenes last weekend in Vegas.
You are making history, so always walk with attitude and passion to do your best.
Amazing story to see Fisk University. There was their schedule, their opening meet in Las Vegas, and they're in Ann Arbor this weekend, and a quad meet in Athens, Georgia. Alicia, pretty amazing story.
It's a great story. Honestly, this is a long time coming, and this has inspired so many athletes to continue following their dreams, and for the NCAA to welcome them into women's gymnastics, I think it was such a great step in the right direction for this program.
Corinne Tarver is their head coach. She's also the athletic director at Fisk University. I had a chance to talk to her quite a bit last week, and just an amazing human being. So fun, so inspirational. Former U.S. national team member, first African-American to win an NCAA all-around title, which is pretty cool. Pretty unique stories. Part of the reason the program came to be is one of the athletes has an uncle that is on the board of trustees for Fisk, and he asked her, where are you going to go to college? And she mentioned all these schools that had gymnastics programs, and he said, why not an HBCU? And he said, well, she said, I want to continue my gymnastics career, and there aren't any schools. That was in conjunction with this movement to get a college program at an HBCU, and those powers to be came together, and they made it happen. I'll tell you what, watch Fisk over the next 5 years. They are going to put forward some outstanding teams, and Corinne and that squad are going to be fun to watch. So we are halfway through here in Lexington. Half-tenth lead for the LSU Tigers over the Kentucky Wildcats. Second half coming up. Welcome back to Rupp Arena. John Roethlisberger, Alicia Quinn here as LSU is visiting the Kentucky Wildcats. As we move to Kentucky and the balance beam, LSU will be on the floor exercise. I always say the competition really doesn't start until you go to beam, Alicia, with Shaylin Luxick here starting things off for the Wildcats.
It is true. I believe beam is the make or break event during a competition. Shaylin with a nice and noty. Strong acro series, back handspring layout step out.
Shaylin Luxick also at a 9.925 for Kentucky on the uneven bars.
Cat jump to switch half. Not fully all the way around. When performing that skill, you want to get both feet facing front and closed together. So the judges probably won't give her full credit for that skill. But it's a very difficult combination she was doing. Gainer Pike. Strong leadoff beam routine for the Wildcats.
Shaylin, a three-time academic All-American. High score in her career on balance beam, 9.95. Leading off for LSU on floor exercise, junior Sierra Ballard.
Starting on the floor for LSU,
a Louisiana
Sierra
native,
Ballard.
North Shore Gymnastics was her club. Jay Clark is actually her uncle.
Sierra opens up with a big double layout. Sierra second tumbling pass for Sierra. Around 1.5 front layup to stag jump. Teammates on the sidelines performing her choreography. It's my favorite part of the floor exercise, is how everybody gets into and to support their teammate. Doing her last tumbling pass. Double pike. And finishes the routine strong. Most floor routines are at max 1:30 long. It is a test of endurance, strength, artistry. This routine was full of difficulty. Opened up with a big double layout and closed out the routine with a double pike.
Sierra's mom, Lori, is a member of the 1988 and 1992 Olympic team for Canada. Gymnastics running in their family. Now back over to the balance beam, Jillian Prokaski. Sophomore. She was also on the vault this evening with a 9.8 there. Was scheduled to go on the bars, and Bailey Bunn took her spot there. Back in the beam lineup. Now she follows Shaylin Luksic's 9.75. So the high end of the country in women's gymnastics, below 9.8s is generally a red flag. You don't want to count scores under a 9.8. Usually mid 9.8s. Or where you want to be, and your top scores being mid-9.9. So that 9.75 for Kentucky is one that they will hope to drop from their beam score.
Jillian's acro series, a back handspring layout step out. Cat jump. Two. An attempted switch ring, which is a very difficult skill. You have to lose sight of the beam by sticking your head back and bringing it back forward. She didn't fully connect, though, so the judges will probably not give her a 10.0 start value. Feet on that landing. Beam is a test of the nerves. Kentucky had good momentum coming into this third event, but they do need to stay focused and not get ahead of themselves. If you let your nerves get the best of you, especially on balance beam, that can be where little mistakes are made that will add up and affect your team score in the end.
This weekend, it's a college basketball Saturday on ESPN and the ESPN app, noon Eastern. It's Kentucky going to my hometown, Knoxville, take on number 5 Tennessee, followed by North Carolina versus Louisville. It is a great day tomorrow for some college hoops.
Next on the floor for LSU, Alona Shinnikova.
Alona Shinnikova next to go for LSU on floor exercise. Sierra Ballard, a 9.85, a very good leadoff spot, score rather. We saw the trouble Alona had on the vault, now trying to bounce back here with a big score on floor exercise in a very tight competition.
In gymnastics, you have to have very short memory. You can't think about the mistakes you made on another event and let that carry over into the rest of the competition. Alone a second pass, round up 1.5 punch front layout. Switch loop two, switch half with the ring. Each skill you perform on the floor exercise is giving a letter value, and that letter value equates to how many tenths that skill is worth. So you can get your bonus points from tumbling, from dance, leaps, turns, all sorts of elements.
Well done from Alona. Jay Clark talks about her as really as important as anybody else on the team that generally gets a lot of the accolades. She kind of goes under the radar a little bit, but he speaks so highly of her and how important she is, really capable on all four events of putting up big scores for the LSU Tigers.
She is just a worker, and she had some clean tumbling. I wouldn't say this is her best routine I've seen her do, but it was a good start for LSU. It is still early in the season, still getting endurance up and getting to where they want their athletes to be.
And I tell you what, I've had a chance to meet Alona and get to know her a little bit through summer camps and such, and she wants this for LSU, and she wants to be a big part of helping this team get to the top of the mountain. And you mentioned it, she's a worker. She works hard, and she is one of the leaders of this team as well. So not maybe the best meet for her here to open conference play so far, but look for her to be a big part of what they do down the stretch. As we see the judges conferencing, trying to figure out what to do with that last routine. I see them making their way back to their chairs, which is generally a good sign.
Means the conference is done. They look very serious in their discussions.
I think that's part of the requisite to be a judge. You're not allowed to be able to smile. Is that accurate?
Maybe. I didn't know that was part of it, but I may look into the rules of judging now for that.
All right, so a little bit of trouble. A tough spot here now for Kentucky. Shaylin Luksic led off, as I mentioned, 9.75. Perkaski in the two spot, a 9.575. So I mentioned they wanted to drop that 9.7. They're going to have to count that 9.7. Now they're going to want to drop. Score is just slightly changed, a 9.55 as Bailey Bunn. Now she is a veteran. She is a junior. And again, a pivotal moment in this dual meet between LSU and Kentucky. Half tenth separates them as they're having a good time, and you might as well have a good time. But a half a tenth separated these two teams coming into this rotation, and now a precarious spot for the Wildcats. They can't let this get away from them here.
They need to definitely put up some rock solid routines moving forward. That being said, they are also going to floor next, which is a strong event for them, and LSU does have to go to beam. So these roles will reverse. The pressure is always hard in the toughest unbalanced beam. So sometimes it's just about surviving the rotation without any major catastrophes and doing the best you can, and then moving on to the next event where you know you can do a little bit better.
Bailey Bunn coming back from a shortened season her sophomore year due to injury, but working her way back to full strength.
Nice three-skill acro series for Bailey Bunn. A beautiful backhand spring layout.
Tim Garrison, rather, said that they have three routines with those triple acro series in their beam lineup. Big risk to take, but if you hit them, it pays off.
It's interesting. Kentucky's been hitting their major tumbling skills, but are struggling on their jumps and their leaps. Bailey just faltered just a bit on that leap connection, and her teammates before that all kind of had a little mishap on that as well.
Double twist dismount right there. Slight step forward, but again, after that 9.575, you want to stop the bleeding and go back and start to build some momentum, and this routine did just that.
This routine was definitely exactly what they needed to get their momentum back to start building scores, because Bailey had a nice, strong acro series and then finished the routine with a double full. Does take a step to the side. The rotation is a little skeptical if they got that all the way around. I'll be interested to see if the judges will award that to her. But finish that routine strong, and I think that's what Kentucky was looking for.
I don't think those are earmuffs. I think those are headphones. And he is just jamming to something right there.
He's listening to Coco Melon in those headphones.
KJ Johnson blasted a vault in that first rotation for a 9.875, and now she follows Alona Shenikova's 9.85. So a pair of 9.85s for LSU to start. And as we mentioned, on the other side of the arena, Kentucky starting with two relatively low scores. So pressure on the Wildcats, big opportunity for the Tigers here.
KJ has some big tumbling. And showed last week she got a 9.5. That was only because her tumbling was so high and she had so much power, she was going out of bounds. But it looks like she figured out how to rein it in this week. So far, so good. That opening full in was great. Second pass, 1.5 front layout. Nice switch stride, straddle full. KJ taking that last breath before her tumbling pass. Closing out with a nice double tuck.
That last landing almost looked like she lifted a foot, thinking she had to step forward, and then realized maybe I don't, but then she did.
I almost thought it was like she felt like a, like almost like a little stinger in her foot and like picked it up quick, but then immediately put it back down because she had control of the landing.
Here's another look right now.
It almost looked like it was a little bit painful.
Yeah, it had a little rebound to that right foot as she's talking to her coaches. Courtney McCool Griffith, their volunteer coach and Olympic silver medalist from 2004. You can see the score now for Bailey Bunn, a big 9.85. They needed that badly. Ariana Patterson in her fifth season here at Kentucky. By the end of last season, she was doing three events regularly. Starting off this season doing three events, Tim Garrison said that she's going to be a big contributor to the team this year.
Handspring, half step out.
Struggled on this event last week in the opener for the season against Ohio State, just a 9.25.
A nice connected front aerial to split jump. Switch leap, hitting 180 degrees, really showcasing her flexibility. Gainer Pike off the end, and she sticks it.
A big routine is what the Kentucky Wildcats needed, and Ariana Patterson absolutely delivered. Tim Garrison told us before the meet how beautiful her lines were and her gymnastics, and I think this beam routine really epitomized that, Alicia.
Her experience is shining through here. It could have been a high-pressure moment for her, knowing that she needs to deliver a good score. And she looked so poised and elegant on the beam and didn't let that affect her at all. And she did an absolutely fantastic routine and really showcasing that stuck landing.
If you told me I had to jog to the end of a 4-inch wide balance beam and flip backwards off the end of it, I'd tell you.
You're moving forward, flipping backwards.
No, thank you. I'm going to pass on that one. That's a hard pass. All right, back over to floor with LSU. All 9.85s, KJ Johnson, the most recent. Here is a big chance for LSU now with three 9.85s already in the book and three routines that easily could go mid-9.9s, and this one's Aaliyah Finnegan.
Lee opens up the very tough tumbling pass, Arabian double front. We talked about it on vault, but when you step backwards from a front skill, it's considered under rotation. The judges don't like that. So unfortunately, they're going to deduct her from that. But that tumbling pass is so hard. It's a blind landing.
And we feel like they did that to her on vault. Her score just a 9.75 there for that small step backwards.
Saves that 2.5 punch front. The risk you run with doing a routine with high value skills is that you could potentially fall on them. Like a 2.5 punch front is a very risky combination. I struggled with that throughout my years as an athlete. Like some meets it's great, some meets you're flat backing it on the front tuck. Aaliyah kept it on her feet and she will continue to push through this full routine. But again, it's not the type of routines we know LSU can do and that they were hoping to do on the floor exercise.
Ooh, struggling a bit here.
Finished 13 on her feet. But again, it's hard when you're early in the season, you still don't have that full endurance yet that you're used to by the close to postseason. And you're still trying to get your feet underneath you. That Raven up front, you see her stepping backwards. Ideally, you want to stick or move to the front with a controlled step into a lunge for no deduction. The 1.5 front layout. Needed a little bit more distance to prevent that under rotation, but she kept it on her feet.
So again, in an opportunity where LSU had a chance to really start to put some distance between them and the Wildcats, maybe gave a few of those tents back. But again, they have two routines yet to go, and they have three hits in the book prior to Aaliyah Finnegan. Now, Raina Worley mounts the bouncing. Ariana Patterson, who, by the way, says her favorite athlete is Raina Worley. She got a 9.925.
Switch side.
I'm pretty sure she's singing the lyrics to this
Raina
song.
Raina is 100% singing the lyrics during her beam routine. I can relate to that on a deep level. I used to bring a portable speaker with me around to each event and like sing to my own playlist, and my coach would get so mad. But hey, if that's what helps you compete and gets you mentally in the zone you need to be in, more power to you. Front aerial to back handspring layout.
Nailed it.
And singing is Raina's thing. I think it works for her. Just the dismount remains. 1.5, and she sticks it!
A mini comeback for the Kentucky Wildcats here on Balance Beam. Started slow, but finishing strong.
The round off to 1.5 twist. Blind landing, you could see her head come around last, and she knows exactly where she's looking at the end of that landing mat to really control that. And her toes digging into the mat, did not want to move those feet. That Raina, was fantastic.
Raina comes out of Christiansburg, Virginia, and Virginia Techniques. Cheryl Johnson is her club coach, hosting a meet there this weekend, and hopefully she took some time off to watch her former star athlete compete here against LSU. If she is, she's got a big smile on her face. Now the pressure kind of shifts back over to the LSU Tigers as Haley Bryant takes the floor.
Opens up with a gigantic front handspring double front.
Aaliyah Finnegan, a 9.5. So that's the low score for LSU so far on the floor exercise. But that score will drop if they can get two more hits.
Front layout to front Rudy. LSU's on back-to-back road meets, and they're having another meet on Monday. So they are probably feeling a little bit tired right now, which is fully understandable and acceptable with having so many meets so close together.
That meet on Monday against the number one team in the country, nonetheless, the Oklahoma Sooners. So quite a start, tough start to the season for them. They had Utah last weekend, one of the top teams in the country.
Haley finishing with a front handspring double full. little unsure of some of her landings and her tumbling. Her first pass was phenomenal, and the second two passes, just you could tell in her face that she wasn't as confident with those landings as she had been in the first tumbling to pass she could perform.
But this, how good was this?
Oh, it gives me goosebumps. It's absolutely outstanding. That front handspring, you can see her legs all come apart and start twisting in the air, which is just gonna make her feel a little bit off.
And you know, and the standards of the rest of us, that was outstanding. But you know the standards of Haley Bryant. You can almost see her face on that last landing. She's like, ugh! Her standard's much higher, and she knows she gave away a tenth or two on landing. So, Raina Worley ties a career high, 9.95. Big chance for Isabella Magnelli here, the junior, to finish strong on an event that did not start that way for the Wildcats.
Another three-skill acro series, and she makes it look simple.
Done with authority.
Beautiful switch leap to straddle quarter. Small balance check on that front aerial. Try to cover up that small balance check. Her back tied to a stick. In case you guys forget how skinny a balance beam is, here's just a little reminder. 4 inches. And these athletes are doing flips, jumps, leaps, turns, all the above, and making it look so simple.
Does it make you break out in, like, cold sweats or anything when you see that? I mean, or is it still like walking a sidewalk for you? Because me, I want to throw
right
up when I
walk my dog. I actually walk on the curb and practice continuing to walk straight and balance beam. I still got it, John.
You would. So Haley Bryant, 9.775. So they will have to count that. And again, just to backtrack, I mentioned 9.7s are not scores you want to count. If you are a team in the SEC, both of these teams are going to have to count a score in the 9-7. Kaya Johnson, she's gotten the 10 on this event. She is capable of big scores. They need one to maintain the lead.
Nice full-in first tumbling pass.
Isabella Magnelli, by the way, a 9.85 in the anchor position for Kentucky.
A nice 1.5 front lay. Beautifully controlled. Nice switch half to straddle full. Very dynamic. Flexibility, hitting 180. Kaya getting ready for her last tumbling pass. A double pike.
Oh no. And obviously we don't know what has happened with Kaya. She has, you can see the tape on her ankle, she has had an Achilles that she has managed throughout her collegiate career, and LSU has really done a great job doing that. Not sure if that's what it is, but obviously it's been a very unfortunate situation for Kaya Johnson and LSU.
LSU team pulling together, trying to keep their focus. It's hard when a teammate goes down like that because you can't let it affect the rest of the meet, but your heart and concern and their well-being is number one in your mind. And she sets it up, the double pike.
Seems fine on the takeoff and very low. At very low landing, and again, certainly not going to speculate, but all we can say is we hope she is okay. Just such an outstanding human being as well as a gymnast, and love watching her, and hope we will get a chance to do that again this year. So hope she's okay, but we're going to shift gears here because we're very fortunate to have Tim Garrison with us. Tim, quite a competition for you guys. It started slow for you on beam, but man, you guys really rallied there the last few routines.
Yeah, I tell you what, that's the impressive part is that although we had a strong vault rotation, got some landings in there better than last week, same on bars, great execution, solid landings. Went over, we had the first couple just did not perform well, and then the back half of that lineup showing tremendous toughness. I was really impressed. That's what we just talked about in the huddle. The first two didn't execute well, but they fought and they stayed tough, and the last four just really let it go. So super impressed with this group at this point.
Coach, we saw that there was a little disturbance during bars in the crowd. Can you tell us what was going on there?
I think we scared a little girl, unfortunately, but she was up there. She had a red flashing light on her camera, and it was right in Raina Worley's eyesight. So we had to take care of that. So unfortunately, I hope she's not too rattled, but well, we got it taken care of before she did her routine.
You got to protect your gymnast. We respect
right.
that.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, good luck on the last rotation. You guys look great, and we look forward to watching you throughout the season. Thanks, Tim.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
Well, very happy that we were right, that it wasn't anything serious as far as the disturbance in the crowd. One more rotation to go, and you can see bottom right of your screen, the Kentucky Wildcats, they will have the lead heading into this fourth and final rotation. Aaliyah Finnegan will try to rally her team as the LSU Tigers go to the balance beam. Meanwhile, Raina Worley, the star for the Kentucky Wildcats, will try to close it out for her team on the floor exercise. Rotation four coming up.
Each meet is so intense. They bring the power.
We always bring out the best in each other.
They're always going to bring their best.
It's always a nail biter.
They bring such energy.
They're going to bring the heat.
We know what we want.
A big one on Monday, number one Oklahoma. They will travel to Baton Rouge to take on the 10th-ranked LSU Tigers in the PMAC. That is a tough place to win no matter who you are. But the Oklahoma Sooners, they are the real deal. You can see their rankings. They're in the top spot on two events, tied for first. But the SEC is a tough place to go. Four of the top 10 teams in the country are teams out of the SEC. You can see LSU down there in 10th. Four more of them are ranked in the top 20. So that'll be a fun one to watch. Don't miss that one Monday as LSU hosts the Oklahoma Sooners. One more rotation to go here from Lexington. The Wildcats trying to hold off the LSU Tigers. They go to floor exercise. LSU goes to balance beam. You're watching the SEC on ESPN. We are in Lexington, Kentucky, and we've got a good one. LSU had the lead through two rotations, but Raina Worley and the Kentucky Wildcats roared back. Unfortunately, Kaya Johnson for LSU had a fall and possibly an injury there on her last routine. So that 0.45 lead, that's big heading into the fourth and final rotation as Kentucky goes to floor. LSU will be on the balance beam. And your all-around standings, we do have an all-around competition taking place here as well. And that is also a good one. Haley Bryant holding off Raina Worley, just 0.025. That's practically a tie. Aaliyah Finnegan, a few steps on those landings on floor exercise. She is about a half a point behind. May need some help from Worley and Bryant to catch him.
Definitely. I think if Aaliyah has a strong beam performance, she's hoping that the other two make a mistake so she can be on top of that leaderboard. But I think right now the biggest thing in LSU's mind is staying focused and getting through balance beam. And then they can all kind of shift their focus and being with Kaya after what happened on floor.
And that is always a tough spot as a team. If you have one of your teammates go down, you got to stay focused, especially in the sport of gymnastics where falls can come so easily. So a lot of pressure here early on Kai Rivers to get the ball rolling in the right direction. Senior from Detroit, Michigan.
Kai rock solid on her backhand spring layout step out. Works her way back into the lineup after coming off an injury.
It's a new life.
Nice switch half. Switch lead straddle quarter. Oh, closes the beam routine out with a nice double twist, fighting for that landing.
Solid start. And there is Kaya Johnson. You can see that left foot wrapped up, and we can just hope that she is going to be okay. She's got a smile on her face, and if you know Kaya, the one thing you know about Kaya is having a positive attitude is not her problem. She is always upbeat and always has a positive outlook, so we will send our best to her. Now Jillian Prokaski will lead things off for Kentucky on floor exercise. A sophomore, member of the SEC All-Freshman team last year.
Jillian opens up with a front layout to front full. Nice switch ring to Georgia Tay half. Second tumbling pass for Jillian. Double tuck. Very well controlled on that landing. Team for Kentucky.
Ty Rivers started things off for LSU with a 9.85 on balance beam. So Prokaski trying to match that score.
Relatively clean routine. Good form on that double tuck.
Next on the beam for LSU, Bryce Wilson.
So 4.5 tenths separating these two teams heading into this final rotation. That is a fairly sizable lead as Bryce Wilson, the freshman, takes the beam for LSU. It is a sizable lead, but if you can chip away at it, a tenth of routine, half tenth of routine, you can make it up if you're LSU.
Bryce opened up the back handspring layup step out acro series. Switch lead to straddle quarter. Just a small balance check on that straddle quarter. Nice front aerial for Bryce.
Oh. Very awkward landing.
Bryce is getting up on her own.
Alicia, it looked like she got off to the side of the beam and then tried to keep going, but her feet weren't on the beam.
Her first back handspring out of her dismount, you could see she was off to the side. And sometimes you can overcorrect the first one to make the second one straight, but it just kept going more to the side.
Here's one more look. See if you can break this down.
That first foot was already off. In her second hand, she missed, and she tried to keep going, but did not have those feet on the beam. Mm.
And you can kind of see her head kind of upper shoulders turn as though she was going to twist into the dismount. But, man, it has been a difficult few routines here for LSU. And, again, most important thing is that Bryce Wilson is okay. Trainer's looking at her now. Back to the gymnastics. Jillian Prokaski for Kentucky led off with a 9-8. We saw the LSU team rallying each other, getting together, and I think the leaders of that team just kind of getting everybody to snap back to attention. They've got some gymnastics yet to do. Ashlyn LeClaire, the senior from Port Crane, New York, now second gymnast to go.
Ashlyn opened up with a big double pike. Switch side straddle for the Wolfle. Second tumbling pass for Hansbring. Front layup, front full. Her last tumbling pass. Front Rudy, a little short on that landing. Unfortunately touches down her hands, which will count as a fall.
The next NBA Saturday matchup on ABC. Teams and some struggles gymnastically and then some potential injuries that we don't know the status of. But again, four routines left for each of these teams. Each of these teams has had some mistakes. The outcome of this competition still hangs in the balance. No pun intended, as we are on the balance beam.
I think it's just a gentle or not so gentle reminder that this sport, these athletes make it look easy, but it is dangerous. They are performing difficult level skills, and though they make it come with some ease, it is something that's very hard, and they're very concerned about the safety of their teammates at all times, and we wish them all nothing but the best.
We saw Ashley Natt, one of the coaches of the LSU Tigers, giving some words to KJ Johnson. Ashley was one of the stars of this LSU team, seems like yesterday. And again, such an important role as a coach, not just teaching gymnastics, but teaching that focus and keeping them on task despite the challenges. Some of them obviously worried about their teammates, but they still have a job to do. KJ Johnson, the next one to do just that here on the balance beam, the sophomore. There's Jay Clark and Kaya Johnson over on the side having a conversation. Waiting on the judges again. This seems like a common theme. Are the judges rusty too early in the season, Alicia?
No, when there's a situation like where there's a fall and the routine isn't completed all the way through, it's going to affect the start value. So then they have to calculate it and see what skills are missing. And so you have to add up how many special requirements that are not there. So it impacts a lot. So the judges have to do a little extra math. And they have to agree upon what is given and what's not.
KJ's had a good night for LSU tonight. 9.85 on floor exercise, 9.875 on vault. She did not perform on the uneven bars.
KJ showing us a planche, showcasing strength, flexibility. I don't know if my body would bend back from that, but it is very impressive.
It would just be there permanently.
Switch leap straddle quarter. Very aggressive, back handspring layout, step out. Aerial. just a little ahead of herself, needs to come back down, get her heart rate normal, and not rush these connections. Handspring, one and a half dismount. Step on that landing.
Bryce Wilson right before her got an 8-6 for that routine. Obviously, that is a score that LSU will likely drop. Ashlyn LeClaire, though, for Kentucky, just a 9-1-2-5, so she had some mistakes. And Kaya Johnson, she's injured, but she is still participating with this team. Smile on her face, and how important is that for the team to see?
She is showing her leadership right there. Yes, it's not the condition she wants to be in. It's not the way she wanted her meet to go, but she's being strong for her teammates and putting on a good face.
Now Isabella Magnelli follows at 9-1-2-5. Critical moments. KJ Johnson had a hit, a few wobbles on that beam routine, but now it's Isabella Magnelli's chance to follow a mistake. She's got a hit.
Isabella opens up with a punch, ready to back layout step out. Switch side straddle fill for Isabella. Double pike. Fall, that's what you are looking for in a teammate. And Isabella delivered a nice hit routine for the Wildcats.
Much needed hit routine as we take one more look.
Form great in that tumbling, her legs glued together. Takes a little bit of a big step backwards, which the judges will knock her for, but for the most part, that routine.
If you are anxiously awaiting the Auburn-Florida meet, that meet will actually start on ESPN News. While we finish up this competition, we hope you'll stick with us. What looks like to be a very exciting finish here. Haley Bryant waits to go on balance beam. KJ Johnson, a 9.575, so they got her for those wobbles that you had mentioned, Alicia. They will have to count that 9.575. Isabella Magnelli's score yet to come in. Let's see how that compares. Should give Kentucky a bit more of a cushion after three gymnasts to go. But for LSU, they got three left to go. Haley Bryant, Aaliyah Finnegan, and Elena Arenas will replace Kaya Johnson. Three athletes very capable of scoring into the 9-9. So this is not over, despite Kentucky's comfortable lead. And I say comfortable because it is not insurmountable. This is not over. Kaya Johnson still cheering on her team. And LSU had five fifth-year gymnasts that moved on after last season. They competed, they're part of the team last season. And that was a big group. And as you have, you know, sophomores becoming juniors, juniors becoming seniors, but you have that big group of fifth years, it kind of inhibits the growth of those juniors and seniors a little bit. But as they moved on, these athletes like Haley Bryant, for example, and Kaya Johnson and Lona Shinnikova now have their chance to kind of move into that leadership position. And right now, it's a big test for these LSU Tiger team. What is your leadership like? Because you just had one of your stars go down, you had another rough routine, and potential injury we don't know from one of your star freshmen. And now your leadership has to take that leadership position. And what do they do, Alicia? How do you get this team to focus?
For these athletes, I don't see them as being the most vocal leaders. They are leading by example. They are showing their team how to conduct themselves with their actions. And you can see the sadness in Haley's eyes because she knows her teammates hurt, but she's going to push that to a side and show that she needs to still compete and deliver when it's her turn. And And that's how you lead your teammates. You have to push through the adversity and show them that, unfortunately, the show must go on. And she's going to get up and perform that routine and do the best of her ability. Beautiful front aerial to back handspring. A nice switch leap straddle quarter for Haley.
Haley is arguably one of the most decorated freshmen in the history of the LSU program. Six All-Americans, NCAA vault title.
This routine has been exactly what the LSU Tigers have needed. Closes out with a punch Rudy dismount, and that was fantastic for Haley Bryant.
A double fist pump from Kaya Johnson, and you talked about leading with their actions, and that right there was Haley Bryant leading with her actions in a must-hit moment for the Tigers.
A moment of respect for the standing punch front. Haley Bryant just did on balance beam. There was no run. There was nothing into it. She did it from a stand. That's how strong and dynamic she is an athlete. I'm having a mom moment. I'm so proud of her for how she handled that. I'm getting teary-eyed thinking, the pressure that she was under.
You're
and
allowed
she just
to
went
have a
and
mom
delivered.
Moment.
It's the hormones, John. There's a lot going on over here.
Let's get back over to floor exercise now. Ariana Patterson follows Isabella Magnelli's 9-8. That score you see in the bottom right, that's still counting an 8-6 for LSU, so you got to keep that in mind.
Ariana opens up with a sky-high 1.5 to punch front layup. Switch half within the ring position. Switch ring to a very dynamic switch side, really showcasing Ariana's flexibility. To close out this floor routine. Double tuck, under rotates a bit, but stays on her feet.
A big step forward, and we've had a lot of moments in this meet where one team has a chance to pull away because the other one made mistakes, and then all of a sudden the script flips and the other team has a chance to pull away. That was a moment for Kentucky where she sticks that landing and it starts to feel like it's over, right?
Oh yeah.
But she puts that big step in there and you're back to going, oh, this is still up for grabs.
That's the beauty and the curse of gymnastics. Anything can happen anytime. These athletes are human. They make mistakes. Nobody's perfect. So it can keep a competition very close to keep you on your toes.
So Ariana Patterson, all smiles nonetheless, and we're going to go over to balance beam, and guess what? There's a judges conference. We need another word for conference because that seems like too kind of a word.
They're having a powwow?
We have had, I don't know, that might be too nice too. They are having a lot of trouble, I feel like, tonight.
It's over Haley Bryant's start value. One judge had it as a 9.9, and the other judges I couldn't see because their backs are to us, but Jay Clark was immediately like, no.
As we mentioned, the LSU schedule coming up is a challenging one throughout this season. They are going to face the top five teams from last year's end-of-season rankings. Missouri is one of those. They finish in the fifth spot. We mentioned Oklahoma. Arkansas really done great things recently as well. So one of the toughest schedules in the country. But if you're in the SEC, you got to go against all the other SEC teams. That means you automatically have one of the toughest schedules in the country. Kentucky knows that too, as we see Leah Finnegan now following in 9.95 from Haley Bryant.
That handspring layup does have a balance check on that landing.
That was an angry balance check.
I'm a firm believer, and if you have like tight, aggressive arms on beam, you can save yourself from most falls unless you're really crooked. And Aaliyah did that. She tightened up quick and made sure she wasn't giving anything else to those judges. Front aerial for Aaliyah. Full off the side, steps on that dismount.
So it does get a hit, a few deductions for Aaliyah Finnegan. We'll see what the judges do momentarily. We're gonna go over to floor exercise. Haley Davis, the junior, walk on her freshman year and sophomore year, got a scholarship this year, and unfortunately this past year lost her father, whom she's dedicated this floor routine to.
It's such a sweet memento she's sending on to her dad. The music of her floor routine are a compilation of all songs that he liked and enjoyed listening to. So for her, this is a really special floor routine, and she attributes to her dad.
Next on the floor for Kentucky.
Heartbreaking story, but a great tribute. And I'm told it's 80s rock that dad used to like. So hang on here for Haley Davis.
With a double pike. Nice switch side to straddle full. One and a half front layout. Double tuck.
That point to the sky at the end, pointing up at her dad. Here's another look.
Haley closed out this routine very well with a nice double tuck. Big old smile on her face.
Next on beat for LSU, Elena Arenas.
So now last gymnast to go for LSU on balance beam, Elena Arenas in for Kaya Johnson. Follows Aaliyah Finnegan's 9.775. With this score, they will drop that 8.6. So if she can put up a 9.8 or better, this is going to go up well over a point for the team score, because they are counting that 8.6 currently in that total bottom right.
Rock solid on her acro series of a back handspring layout step out. Front toss. 2 feet landing.
Haley Davis on floor just flirted with a career high. It's a 9.925, just behind her career high of a 9.95. What a performance.
Yeah. switch half for Elena. Sticks that 1.5 dismount.
Clutch. Put in the lineup last minute. And that is a clutch, gutty performance. Trying to give LSU a chance. Aaliyah Finnegan right before her, a 9.775. And this should be a big score, though, for Arenas.
There was not many areas where they could deduct in that routine. She did a flawless performance, or near flawless, I should say, because, you know, judges can be a little fickle with their scores. But in a high-pressure situation where she wanted to hit for her team, that was a very well-done performance.
Fickle.
Fickle.
Nice way to put it.
Thank you.
Raina Worley now trying to close things out for Kentucky. This is a new floor team for her as well. And Tim Garrison told us that Elise Ray, Olympian from 2000, bronze medalist, NCAA champion from Michigan, former head coach at the University of Washington, choreographed this routine for her.
Raina opens up with a huge full in.
.925 for Elena Arenas. That is a career high for her.
His next time on the pass, front full to front layout.
Just has to put it on her feet.
Last solo class, I'm at stress for Raina. Nails that double tuck.
Raina Worley, she just needed better than a 9-4 or better for Kentucky to get just their 10th win against LSU. Coming in is 84 wins for LSU, 9 for Kentucky. The magic number 10, Alicia.
This atmosphere. This team, it wasn't an easy competition for either side, and they fought through to the very end.
Look at the end. Another note, though, if she gets a 9.975, she ties Haley Bryant for the all-around.
And now we wait.
I'm not sure if that's a stick boa or if that's just an I'm happy boa.
Because they
get it.
Happy boa.
They get it every time. And well deserved, though, for Raina Worley as we see LSU. A few sullen faces, certainly not the meet they wanted, and certainly more than a score or a win or loss, they are concerned about their teammates right now. Raina Worley, interesting story. Raina, I've known her since she was a very young gymnast, and she used to come to my camp, and one of our coaches, Kristen O'Shields at the time, Kristen Jones now, she was a Kentucky Wildcat, called Tim Garrison and said, hey, you might want to check out this Raina Worley. She's pretty darn good. Let's just say Tim Garrison owes Kristen Jones, we call her Osh, owes her one, because what an addition to this Kentucky Wildcat team she has been in her fourth season. Haley Bryant, she does get the all-around title, her 10th in her career with that 39.575. The score for Raina Worley, a 9.925. So just shy in that duel with her and Haley Bryant. That'll be a fun duo to watch throughout the season here in the SEC. Look for them to be atop a lot of the all-around standings.
Definitely. I know Haley's probably struggling with her emotions, but she's still had a great showing for herself and for her team. And it's going to be a trying little time for LSU right now, but they're going to pull together and they're going to keep competing to the best of their abilities. But a great competition for Kentucky tonight.
And that is a big score, over a 197 for the Kentucky Wildcats. They get their 10th win over LSU. Congratulations to them. For Alicia Quinn, I am John Roethlisberger. Congratulations to Kentucky, as we'll say so long from Lexington.